We continue with the lecture of the chapter Geography. Agriculture is the chapter's name. We had learned in the prior thing what is agriculture, what kind of factors affect agriculture and all. Now we learn what kind of farming is available all over the world, what kind of farming takes place. So before knowing what are the kinds of farming that take place, let's see what is needed for farming in the very first place. You need the geographical conditions, the favorable geographical conditions. You need good climate, you need good soil, you need appropriate rain for irrigation and all. You need labor. Availability of labor is one of the most important criteria over there. Demand of the produce. If you're producing something, if you're growing something, how many people are actually asking for it? Like, how many of them are your consumers? How developed is the technology in that area is a very major concern for farming as well. So taking into consideration all these parameters, we can divide the types of farming under two major categories. One is subsistence and the other one is commercial. Now, subsistence, let's take for this particular lecture. Commercial I'll deal with later. What is subsistence farming? Subsistence farming is low scale farming. That means the produce, the yield will not be too high. That means the farmer is actually producing it for himself. He doesn't have consumers. He will not go and sell his produce or eat. He is producing it for himself. He'll have a small plot of land. He will have simple tools. The labor will be actually the family members. He will not hire laborers because he's got a small plot of land. So this is the essence of subsistence farming. But subsistence farming also has got two categories under it. Intensive subsistence farming and primitive subsistence farming. When you talk about intensive subsistence farming, the same concept comes in. The plot is small. The people working over there are lesser in number because the requirement of people who do to work over there is less. The work is handled within the family. The irrigation method is age old. They will not use any modern technology over there. They'll work by hands. Manual labor will be involved and the tools will be simple because they don't have to produce a lot and they have only a little to produce. But the climate is very favorable to them. The soil is also fertile, which allows them to grow multiple crops in a year. That means they grow a crop, then they for like 3-4 months they're growing that particular crop. Again, next 4 months they'll be growing something else. Again, 4 months they'll be growing something else. That suffices their family needs. They're growing for themselves. Now, the main crop in this kind of a cultivation is rice, wheat, maize, millets. Pulses also they grow. Now this kind of farming you will see in Southeast and East Asia. These people are like they are self-dependent. They rely upon their own agricultural methods and they don't go to the market and buy produce. They grow for themselves. So the next comes primitive. Now primitive technology, the primitive method has got two main categories under it: shifting cultivation and nomadic herding. What do you mean by shifting cultivation? If you remember, I have taught you this in history. Shifting cultivation means they clear a part of the thick forest, they cut off the trees, they burn the dense area, which is shrubs and all, they burn it and they spread the ash all over on the area which they have cleared. This kind of cultivation is also called slash and burn cultivation method. So they cut off the trees, they burn that particular area and then they spread the ash all over and they start cultivating crops over there. Now, why is it called shifting cultivation? Because when they keep growing over there, and when once the soil loses its fertility, the capacity of giving good yields, they leave that particular area and go to some other area of the forest and continue doing the same. But they leave this land for years together. It becomes fertile again because again things grow, start growing over there, and the plants fix the nitrogen and all. It goes on. The cycle goes on. So every part of the forest is explored, leaving one part for it to revive on for itself. That is called shifting cultivation, and it's also called as slash and burn cultivation method. You will find this in Amazon basin. You will also find it in Northeast India also. This particular cultivation method is followed. Now the main things which are grown over here are maize, yam. Yam, most of you must not be knowing. Ye hota hai kand, hota hai kand, which grows underground. Okay, so it's huge in size. And cassava. So these are the items which are grown. These are the food items which are grown by the with the help of shifting cultivation. Next comes nomadic herding. Nomadic herding is actually followed by people who are living in arid areas and semi-arid areas. Arid is dry, totally dry, that means I'm talking about a desert. And if you say semi-arid, you would say a part of the place gets rainfall, but it is dry. Now the logic is what is nomad? Like, nomad is a person who moves from one place to the other. So why does a person move from one place to the other? Is they have herds of cattle and they have domesticated animals who need fresh pastures for their feeding the animals. They need fresh pastures. Now certain places at certain areas, certain climatic conditions don't suit them. So they leave that particular area and go to the place where the climatic conditions are better for that particular part of the year. Fine. So these people have defined routes. They don't go just anywhere and settle. They have defined routes. Defined routes, defined months of the year where to spend. And they take their cattle. The main reason of them moving around is the cattle only, like are the domesticated animals only, so that they can find fresh pastures for them. So they move around from one place to the other because of the climate and because of the availability of resources at that particular moment wherever they are staying. Now they have animals like sheep, yak, camels, goats. They have such animals. And what do they get from them? They get from them milk, they get from them meat, they get from them wool. So these are the things which they have to get from the animals so that they move from one place to the another. So this is the synopsis of entire thing, types of farming. We finished off with subsistence just now. Intensive subsistence, primitive subsistence, under primitive we have got shifting cultivation and nomadic herding. In the next lecture, I will take up what is the commercial type of farming, because commercial is totally different from subsistence over here. That involves high yield of produce. Here you sell and here you don't sell, you do it for yourself, for your family to survive throughout the year. You grow it for yourself. That's all for today's lecture. Thank you, dear.